So, can you tell me about yourself?
Okay, so myself Kapil, I'm from Ghaziabad. And hello, are you listening?
Yeah, I'm listening. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah. So myself Kapil, I'm from Ghaziabad, and I have completed my graduation from Uttar Pradesh Technical University. And I have started my career from QA Infotech as a software test engineer. And after that, I worked in an impact QA as a software test engineer also. And due to pandemic into December 2019, I left my job. I left my job. And my hobbies is I am listening music and surfing web and all that things. So
Okay.
I have many experience in manual testing. I have worked on e-learning platform Maximum. So I have bit knowledge of REST Assured API testing also.
Yeah, so this our answer is there, right? That don't look right. So you say the people are not interested to get from where you are, right? So if I have answered this, I will say okay, I am Kapil, and I've done my BTech or whatever in this year. Right, and after that, see you, whatever you work, see you go to any company you work, you have some experience in a company. That doesn't matter software or not, you know how to interact with the people, right? That is the experience you get. So you should also say, okay, initially I work in the HR space, and then you should not tell your negatives, right? You're telling your negatives, so you should not tell your negatives. You should tell all your positive, and if you tell informing your negative also, you should tell in positive, like so. Let me open your LinkedIn profile. So if I have to tell about you, right? If I say I'm Kapil, and I've done my BTech from UPTU, and college name you're done in computer science, right? So that is important. So you should say I did my computer science 2012, and the initial area you got a placement there, right? No, you don't get placement. So you say I work for this IT recruitment. And then since April 2017, I'm working in the QA space. I work in a QA Infotech from 2017 to 3 year, right? Almost 3 year you work there, right?
No, to one point something.
Yeah, so that you say I work in 1.5 right there, and then I work as a impact QA from this time to this time over here, right? So they are interested in what you bring to table, and then you should tell you about your skill. So you say now what? So I have done manual testing, and I know I have also using automated testing using REST Assure, which I just use for a little time. And I have been earlier testing the manual testing of the EMS system. So that's how you introduce should be the right. You're from Ghaziabad. My hobbies are this, right? See, interview what actually happened in the interview, right? Okay, they ask you, okay, tell me about yourself, but it's most of the time it is the answer because people are re-seeing your resume. They have not seen your resume earlier. So you should not tell my hobbies, suffering and all this, and that is everybody suffering, right? That how add value to them, right? Then you can say, okay, I like to read out. If something is there, then you tell it, right? Don't go here and there. Because if you go here and there, right, you have like 45 minute or 1 hour time. And you tell a good point about it. Don't go here and there. That is my suggestion. Okay, so what are the tools and technology you know?
I know Jira,
Okay.
Mozilla. For manual testing, I have used that management tools.
Okay, so I think how you should represent this, right? So I say, I see I done the manual testing, and I've done some very small automated testing with the REST Assure. And so first thing you should tell the main point, right? Manual testing. So I've done manual testing of the LMS system and this thing. And in the tools I use Jira and this Bugzilla, right? Bugzilla you use, right? Yeah. So do you which and you work in Agile or you work in Waterfall? Okay, so what is Agile?
Agile is a methodology.
You are giving the
testing
point answer, like,
methodology.
so then what I do with it, right? What is agile, right?
Basically, agile is a methodology, and it is the latest. We can say it is the post methodology of waterfall. It is the replace of waterfall due to some negative in a waterfall. So agile is a in agile we worked with the developer and tester and master scrum master as well together as well.
Okay, right. So see how when you answering it, I'm asking what is the TV, and you say with TV you can connect with your USB. So first thing when you ask, right, so you have to tell the primary thing associated with it, right? So what is agile, right? So if somebody asks me what is agile, how I will answer, I will say okay, agile is a methodology. And earlier we have waterfall over there, right? What happened? If somebody will answer me, right, it is a little hard to mimic, but still I try to do. Yeah, so agile methodology is there, right? Earlier people used to use waterfall, and that has a problem because in the waterfall, maybe after the 6 months or 1 year or 2 years, customer will see the right project, and the project could be not in the as per requirement document, right? There could be some communication, right? And delta could be there. So agile come, and agile basically will have earlier feedback, right? So you will have iteration, right?
Yeah.
So agile will have an iteration so that it will show the after every iteration show to the customer. So we get a feedback, and there are two methodology. Then agile is a methodology, but there is a scrum is there, and Kanban, two are there, right?
Yeah.
So you work in Scrum or Kanban?
Scrum.
Yeah. Okay. So Scrum is there, right? So then you say, okay, I don't say Kanban and Scrum is there. I don't like to more educate you because that is not time. So you can say I work in Scrum. So in Scrum, what is there? Okay, there is to every month there will be some iteration will be there, right? And you will have a story. I think you understand it, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you will have a story, and every iteration will be there. Iteration could be from. It can be up to one month. Right? Shorter the iteration, better it is, right? Because in what happens, shorter the intervals, you get feedback faster.
Next 3 weeks.
No, you can have 4 weeks. I have seen 1 month also. They don't say more than 1 month, but yeah, you can have till 1 month. And some people have done 2-3 days also Scrum. That is when you do in DevOps. Some people have done in DevOps 2-3 days, but usually it's 1 week to 1 month.
Okay.
So this is the right, and you have a Scrum Master, and it is self-organizing team, right? It's not that, and there is a product. All those people are there, right? So it have so different thing. So okay, so you have to refine little, right? You have to keep giving more interview. So I think it will come with experience. Okay. So this is the Kanban, and there's a, do you know any estimation technique?
Yeah, I know. I estimated many, many times.
See, you are giving the answer, which is not. So you say I estimate many times. So, but how I get, you should tell me some name of the estimate techniques, right?
Actually, I have not used any particular technique, but, we have used manually estimated, like there is in my project there is a sub many type of testing, so depends on the like video testing, when we come in video testing, when how much time we have take to a test a video. And that time we have estimated like that, and after that we have provided all resources to that estimate, and according to estimate we have provided resources 8 hours on per resource.
Okay, no. So see, estimate taking, there is something called t-shirt sizing, right? So t-shirt come in small, medium, large, extra large, right? So I'm just telling you, right? So you can say like. Yeah, one is a ballpark number, right? Which estimate you're doing is ballpark number based on your guts. You say, okay, this much time it takes. So this estimate technique called the ballpark estimation technique.
पार्क.
हाँ, यू से जैसे बॉल पार्क राइट, यू से सम एस्टिमेट इतना टाइम लगेगा लगभग.
ओके 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 ओके
एंड देन अगेन कम टी शर्ट साइजिंग. सो टी शर्ट कम स्मॉल मीडियम लार्ज एक्स्ट्रा लार्ज एंड डबल एक्सएल राइट.
ओके ओके
सो यू से के सो यू शुड से कि आई नो आई हैव नॉट यूज्ड दिस डिफरेंट थिंग, और यू कैन से के सो दैट इज वन थिंग राइट. सो यू शुड नॉट से के आई एम नॉट आई हैव यूज्ड लाइक गट्स फीलिंग ओनली राइट, बिकॉज that is not very good. So there is small, there's a one more technique is there which called t-shirt sizing. And the
ओके
t-shirt
ओके
sizing what happen के you will say के small, medium, large or extra large right,
ओके
and
ओके
they go
ओके
in Fibonacci series right, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 7, 8 right, and
ओके
one story should not be more than 8 point.
ओके
Okay, so
ओके
story point, 1 point you can assume is 1 day. I don't like to go by theory. Point is not equal to day, but you can say we roughly can assume point is a 1 day, but that is not true. But that is a in-depth training itself, a house scrum work, right? And then one thing you should say function point testing, right? So you will see ke, I will see ke how many. So if you are testing a library, right? So how many function point you have to test login, you have to test video is coming or not coming. All those scenario, right? You have to test it. So more and more functionality come, it will keep increasing the complexity because the combination part will come, more different PNC will come, right? And if you have not estimated something, if you have a historical data is there, right? If you have estimated earlier, then you know okay, okay I have tested video thing earlier, and it will not take much time. It will take 1 day. Like, but if a new person is coming, then it will take more time to you estimate. So that's how you should say, yeah. So there's ballpark is there, t-shirt sizing, and there one more poker planning is there. So poker planning, what happened? The whole team sit and they say, I will send you recording of this video to you also, upload to YouTube and send to you also. So in the ballpark number, so in ballpark in number is there, t-shirt planning is there, function point is there, and you have this poker planning. So in poker planning, what happened? Okay, whole team sit and they will play like card game. So I will say story is 2, and somebody will say 3, and somebody say 5, and this, and you can, there are two way to come to output. You can say, you can average out, and then you will discuss okay, why there is a delta is there, and then we discuss within the team. You see, you don't take in poker planning, you don't take average. Every put the card, okay, this is 1, somebody says 5, then people will discuss okay, why you are thinking 1 and why you're thinking 5, why there's so much difference is there. If there's no difference, everybody say 3, 3, 3, 3, that is fine. But if you somebody say 1, somebody say 5, 5 point means 1 day, you can say point is equal to 1 day, but that is not true. But it's roughly you can say, but don't say a point is equal to 1 day, but you can say I usually take point as a day only. I think that will be fair for you. So then if there's a difference is there, then people discuss over there, okay, why you think 1, and you say size. So who thinking 1, right? He maybe is very good in that, expert in that area, and who's saving 5, he may be not having any idea about it, right? So then we can discuss okay. So you get to always say okay, there is a positivity is there, so we have to discuss within the team and we come with the estimate over there, right? Okay, so do you understand what is SDLC?
Software
What is
life
SDLC?
cycle, developing life cycle, SDLC.
See, you have to always little descriptive, right? I'm not asking full form. You have to at least, it should not be like, it's not an objective question. You say yes and no. So what is SDLC? So SDLC is a software development life cycle, and it has different phases, right? And nowadays what happened in the video call, they can ask you to turn off a video. You can open a laptop beside your mobile, or you can just Google it. I think, but don't make it to them. If a video they turn off, just Google it. I think it is fair. You say SDLC because many things are there, right? You will be better. So you just, I'm also right now Googling on my other laptop because I also don't remember. So the planning, design, maintenance, and planning. So you should remember okay, all those things are there, and it will obviously there will be some planning will be there, then analysis, design, implement, and this loop will go for forever. Even it's waterfall or it's a agile in the both the thing. Obviously SDLC will be there, right? Software development life cycle. So as we have human life cycle, we born, we educate, we get married, we have kid, we get old, we die, right? and then we this is the same thing
like
as DLC, right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, so how you do testing? If I ask you to do testing of a and see, you should know about their product also, right? So if I am see building I'm building a corona testing kit, right? So people can order for that testing kit, and that person will come and they will test the system. So how you will test such a web interface?
Please come again.
No,
I
have a business, right?
Yeah,
I have a business where people can order their corona kit, and then our representative will come. You can book an appointment, and the person will come and they will do your testing on your home. So we are building a web interface for it. So how you will test the system?
How will please come again one more time. I am trying to understand this question. Please.
So basically, what I'm trying to say, right? I'm trying to say you to this, right? Obviously, there will be web pages there, right? So I'm asking how you test this website, right? Where people can log in and they can order their corona for, they can book appointment for their, they can book their appointment, they can book their appointment for come at home, right? And then the person will, other person will also log in and they will see, okay, there's, I got a pickup for this, the person will go there. So this is a website and it's like an Amazon kind of ecosystem, right? So you have to be a little descriptive in answer. You just don't say, okay, what is SDLC, don't say software development lifecycle. Always try to tell at least four more sentences. So it is a software development lifecycle, and there is a like plan, analysis, design, implement, maintenance, change. And if he asks you to turn off the video, you can just Google it also, right? So because once you Google it, you also know it, right? So if it even didn't help you in this interview, it will help you in next interview. So when are you joining in next company?
From next month.
Okay, I thought you have taken some buffer. Okay. Now, what is the date?
Maybe 3 or 4.
Okay.
He said me, I will call you 3 or 4. Between 3 or 4, he will join.
3 or 4 February, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you have to be a little less cautious. Next month it become a little abstract. So you have to be, let's say, okay, I will join next around 3rd and 4th February.
Okay.
And you are in the bench, right? So now if you have offer, you are a little edge. You are a little hot cake in the market. Yeah, right. So you should understand this. So so how you will test system? So you will say, okay, there will be different module will be there, right? You say there will be login module will be there. There will be admin page. There will be page for user. There will be page for guy, right? And this yeah. Use cases are there. And so first you understand requirement, right? So don't directly jump into the solution. If you have more question, first think, okay, what are the questions? So you say, okay, what are the module going to be there? They're going to be admin module. They're going to be user module. They're going to be person who going to have this, right? And then we going to have different use case, okay, login use case. So if I have to test a login, right, how you will test?
I click on login button and I check his its functionality. After clicking on login button, login page is login interface is UI interface is coming smoothly or not. We have after that we have mentioned valid credentials and click on login button. If I navigate to a particular page, then the functionality is working fine. If I don't navigate on a particular page, then the functionality have some issues.
I think you are asking very in detail, right? We want to see a little higher level picture. So you say, okay, there could be, we'll see positive and negative test case, right? That's how you do, right?
Yeah.
So you should start with a little high level. See, it's not just you have to start high level, then you have to drill down, right? So there should, when you are speaking, right, you should arrange your content in your mind, right? Okay, heart, it's not, it always better you take a 5-10 second pause and you think, right? You organize content in your mind. Okay, what I'm going to say. So you will say, okay, okay, they're going to positive cases, negative cases. I'm not from testing domain, so if I have been Java, I could have been giving you more in depth what exactly question ask, because I'm not taking a testing guy interview. So basically, okay, I will test from answer you saying, right, if somebody asks my company to go and there's a 2-year experience guy, QA, and if he answer like this, I will not be happy. Right. Okay. So at least for me, right, I'm not a testing background, and there are a lot of things are there, right? So you say, okay, they're going to positive test cases and negative test cases, right? So first, people don't talk about negative test cases, right? People talk about happy scenario, but it don't happen to login, right? So first will be like, is login page is coming or not coming, right? This is also one test, right?
Yeah.
Yes. And you have to talk about negative also. And then he put right username and password. And then we see, okay, what are the character allowed in the username, space not allowed, right? Is it allowing that, and password is there, is minimum length is there. If you put right username and wrong password, and right username wrong password, or wrong user, like we see all this combination over there, right? And you're not doing security testing. So you will say like this. So first you think, what are the list of the use cases and positive use cases and negative use cases.
Okay.
So that is what is there, right? So what is... what are the different level of test cases?
Different level?
Yeah, there's a unit component or program test. Integration testing, system testing, etc.
There are different type of testing. Integration, functional integration, retesting. There are the different testing. Yeah, different type of testing.
No, there basically I'm googling it. There's a, you have to Google, right? A top interview question, right? And let me share my screen.
Unit testing, alpha testing, beta testing, black box, white box.
So this is here to tell, right? So just say testing interview question, right? So you see, first Google is always like good. So you just say, and I think you should go for all these 150 questions, because the most likely something they will ask. Right,
okay.
Even somebody asked me if I don't know anything about, I know testing, right? But I don't know testing as a tester, like, you know, who was like pro in testing from 5 or 7 year experience guy. But I know basic of testing, right? So you should read 150 question given. You should read this care, whatever given here, what is use case testing? What is traceability metrics? And you should be able to relate this thing to your work. And you have to prove that I have done this thing. And even if you've not done it, before the interview, you can think, okay, we have a traceability metric. Somewhere you have to get a little supposition, but this company is not that much. So you say, okay, obviously, so what, there is one question I like it in this thing, black white busting, you know, black testing, static dynamic verification, different testing level integration, traceability metrics, right? What is traceability metrics? Yeah, so this is basically testability, relation between the test cases and requirement, right? There should be, many people are working in service industry, right? So they want, have you really tested? What is the proof that you have worked it, right? So you will have you have a Jira, right? So in Jira, you have not done all those things, right? You write the test cases and somebody, tomorrow client come and say, okay, this thing goes wrong. You have not tested. How you prove that, right? You go to your Jira test cases and their test cases are written, right? Manual test cases.
Yeah.
So those things are important, right? You should know traceability metrics, right? And there is I ask you 4 type of testing. Is there one acceptance testing? What is acceptance testing?
A user acceptance testing, where user is accept that when we have test to front of view of a user, We have tested on website. We have tested any application. So that kind of testing is known as user acceptance testing.
I think you're going a little left and right. And see, what is the problem happening with, I think, lower experience guy? And they try to answer the question, but they talk little, they hit around the bush, but they don't hit the core part. So acceptance testing could be user acceptance testing, right? Where people write the requirement. So there are like, they write a acceptance criteria in Jira. So in Jira, they write ke, when user put a user there, so there is a, he put a acceptance testing for login, right? So you just say, as I log in, when I log in with username and write username and password, I should be shown to, I should be going to my order pages if order is there. Or if it is new customer, then they will to other acceptance criteria, right? Okay, when user log in and he's coming the first time, and then we will show him a quick tour of the product, right? And when a administrator log in, he will show to this, right? If user log in, if somebody user log in, it log in first time, it will show him to set up his profile. So there is a standard format, like, as a customer when I log in, right? This thing called, I think, behavior driven
BDD.
Yeah, behave. So don't go to, if you talk something about it, you should be knowing, right? So behavior driven testing, I think this thing happened. Okay, you say, okay, when this thing is done, when as a customer, I do this action, then this thing should happen. Right? Because in Agile, don't say okay, you should build a perfect product, but you should like ship out something within the stream, right? So there is a time resource and money, right? These are the three limitation factor of anything, right? So if you I say I give you very less money, very very less time, and I the quality, so this is also called QA, right? Quality assurance. There is this thing. You have to control the quality. You cannot complete all three parameters, which is your time, resource, and money. So you say, I give you very less time, very less resource, and very less time, and I want high quality. That is not possible, right? You have to increase something, right? You have to increase the time. Or it's not just these are the very good some quotation you have to do, right? It's not that nine mother can deliver a baby in 1 month, right? That is also you can tell such example which shows that you have in-depth understanding of the system. See, more you say like QA people don't accept more, but I think whatever you're talking, it should be good. If you say rest assured, I know I just say just started, right? Because the Java is there, so then people is asking Java programming. So how long you use rest assured in a company?
Actually, I learned. I'm learning rest assured from my own basis. I have not used rest API on real time application. I am learning on my own, and I am using some demo APIs for testing purpose.
Yeah.
Because I am in learning phase of rest assured, so I am trying to learn on daily basis. So I'm taking a demo. Demo APIs from some application, and I'm trying to automate on that APIs.
So you are writing code in Java or Python, which language?
Java.
So you know, see, more open door you open, right, and then he will try to enter more ways. So you have to always set expectation, exceed it. So that is the thing. Okay, let me pass your profile to him. Let's see, is there a take or not take, if they have a manual, right? But I will send you recording of this, right? So you can see, and I think you should see this, just Google it, one testing interview question, and there are 150 questions are there.
Okay.
But I
learned many things to you. Thank you for that.
So that you should go all those things, what is the scope? Test plan, what the test plan consists of, right? This is the question coming here, right? So you would have made the test plan also. So they will ask what is the test plan consist, feature to be, which is not to be tested, and how you do the testing. So you say how you review your test cases.
Sorry?
How you review it? So you have to do a manual testing. So how you review your test cases?
I review one by one. When I get it, when I get test plan, I review one by one. I reviewed that test case and implement on my application. And
with whom you review it, right?
My team lead.
And do you developer review with your developer? They can come with some more test cases. There could be some gap you have missed.
Basically, yeah, I many time I review with my lead.
You should say I write the leader. Test cases and I review with the lead, and then we have a meeting with the developer also where we tell them test cases. Right, so they also come with some test cases. So I think this is a good practice, right? Something, some fake you have to do, right, to show that your work little nicer, right? So you say we have write the test cases, we review the lead, and then we also have a review with iteration. So how long your iteration was?
3 weeks.
Yeah, so you say after like we have the test plan, and after like two, three days, we write the test case and we review with the team. Yeah, these are the test cases are there, and they tell us something in the test cases, something I'm missing there, right? Yeah, is there any positive and all those things, right? So you should tell this thing, we have a review with Alto. So it shows that you work in more process-oriented company, which you order a process. So because, see, when you go to a company, right, they want the person should know everything, whatever they require. They don't like to have a time for building, right? So that is a required thing, and you have to showcase it, and you have to little hide your weak points. But so what is your weakness?
What is my weakness? Maybe as a point of interview, I can say that I have no weakness.
No, you cannot say this, right? You can say, so how you can tell, right? If somebody asks me in the company, what is your weakness? You can make it a rumor also, right? As for me, I say, you can tell something, you have to answer something. So you can say, you cannot say you don't have weakness, then you're Superman or you're God. So how easily say, I'm very lazy in the morning. If you ask me to, I can wake up till 5 a.m. But if you ask me to get up morning, it's 6, 7 a.m. I cannot wake up. So that is my weakness, right? So you make it a little rumor also, and basically that is being human. Is you cannot be like Superman.
Okay. Your voice is breaking. Hello? Hello? Can I reconnect you? Actually, your voice is not coming.